make of Denizui's newest acquisition?
I've known the group for a long time. It makes perfect sense. Remember, he has 500 plus stores, so he can easily get economies of scale that the previous owners were not able to achieve because of his 500 retail stores, and that should improve the profitability. And then also, Kathy, remember, he already acquired Togo a few months back, so this could be a logistics play where he could use FamilyMart as a tie-up for distribution, especially for distributing other value-added services in retail stores. Because I recall even 7-Eleven is looking to that, and that's going to increase the sales significantly.
So how soon before we see the value of this proposition coming to the stock price?
It will probably take a while, Kathy, because, of course, in addition to the normal closing conditions, the fact that there are not many stores yet, it will probably take at least half a year maybe to get a significant number of FamilyMart stores in the Phoenix Petroleum stations, right? Because there could be tenants there or tenants there occupying some of the spaces, so they have to terminate that or they have to shift some of the existing convenience stores to FamilyMart. But once that's there, then you have the rollout. And because I'm a FamilyMart customer also, and very happy with their product. So once you have that convenience, I think you'll see it occur to the bottom line of it.
All right. So how do you think we'll trade when the markets reopen Thursday? It's going to be pretty quiet, but investors will be waiting for President Trump's announcement of the next Fed chief.
Yes, it depends on the Fed announcement. I guess if it chooses someone who is really supportive of growing the economy, then it'll be positive for the market. But it depends again who chooses. So we even have a bet in that PBO, but it's pretty up in the air. But then again, because of the long holidays, it's likely that the markets will be very light. There'll be very little volume anyway.
All right. As President Duterte is in Japan, 6 billion pesos so far in investment pledges, with some infra projects to boot. How's the pace at which the infra projects are coming along, if at all, moving?
That we're very excited with, right? We think that especially Japan has been one of the prime movers, and with Japan supporting and it will have more pledges, we should anticipate a big push in the infrastructure. Of course, those pledges will come to fruition maybe next year, so we'll feel it in 2018. But that will be very good for the country.
All right. I won't keep you longer, Ed. Have fun on the 2-day holiday while we fight the invisible fires here in the newsroom.